people, welcome back to my channel. Hola, bienvenida a mi canal. Salut les amis, bienvenue et bon retour sur ma chaîne. Konnichiwa, watashi no channel ni yokoso. I'm speaking a lot of languages, but I'm having a lot more people from around the world. Really happy about that, and although I speak English all the time, French is my first language, so to do like subtitles, but it's just a matter of like having time to do it. It takes a lot of time. I just hope you're doing fine, all of you. Second video of the week, so before going any further, please subscribe. It's free, full of adventure. I do fashion, I give fashion advice twice a week, Tuesday, Thursday at 3 PM Eastern time, so this is not gonna change. Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter. So everything is gonna be linked in the description box below as usual, of course. I have my website, which is www.aprenshop.com, and on there you're gonna find a lot of stuff. Everything is gonna be in the down below, but a monthly magazine at the first of each month, and I'm gonna try to have a French version. Let me know if you want it, and if you do, I'm gonna try to like work on the two versions. It's really interesting for you guys. I'm gonna try to have like version as well as like Spanish, Japanese, speak French, English, little bit of Spanish, Japanese, Chinese, Korean, little bit. If you want to see more of that, just let me know and I'm gonna be more than glad to do it. As you saw on the first part of this video, there was a lookbook and it was all dedicated to pastel colors. Using everywhere. I'm really loving it more and more and more and more just because also pastel colors have my favorite. I have the pink, the light pink, dusty pink. If I eat like every single day when I think about like pastel, but for me it was not a challenge just because I really really wanted to add much more pastel to my wardrobe, still staying true to myself. I had so much fun doing it. I had so much fun. It's amazing for me to be able to just like use everything that I had and use everything that I've seen so far and see how I could appropriate it. So here is gonna be the part that I'm gonna tell you all about like the main rules when it comes to pastel colors. Instead of going through each outfit, I think, or I thought it was a really better idea for me personally to just explain to you like what would be like the main guides, if I could say it like that, when it comes to pastel colors and how you can do it yourself. Everything is gonna be linked in the description box below. Everything similar that I'm probably not gonna find because I've had it for like years now, I'm gonna link everything similar to it in the description box below as usual. Like summarize the keys or the main keys in order to just like let you be able to just like styling in your own spices, with your own spices and with your own soap. Let's get started. All pastel colors, it's anything that is really like any lighter shade that I really really like. It's gonna be the baby blue, the dusty pink, the light yellow, or you can have other shades that would be like much more like bright, like lemon, really bright green. You have a lot of options when it comes to it. So that's what we call pastel colors. The first rule is for anybody that just not into pastel colors, because if you're not a fan of having super bright colors on you, it's okay as well, because you don't have to have bright colors on you in order to look stylish. Of course, you have like options, have maybe an accessory. A really pastel bright accessory is really the way to go. If you want everything else to be really basic color-ish, you can go with a really great accessory, and I'm gonna give you an example here. One from Primark, to me, I think it's just a really great way. You have a lot of colors in here. You have the bright pink, you have the lilac, you have a lot here, and it was perfect for night out or just like to go out in general. The rest of the outfit was really really like basic in terms of like colors, all about being like super laid back but have the accessory for it. But it 2 years ago, tried to find similar options with super bright, super stylish, and then because it's a clutch, it's something that you can like remove or hide if you don't want to see any color on you. The second rule that I'm gonna have here is to stay within the same color or same shade. It's about like showing you that you still, if you are not so much into pastel colors or you don't want to combine anything, you want to have something really 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 simple, you still can do it. But it's just a matter of how you can combine the outfit. Because one of the outfit I'm gonna show you nice clip here. What I love was like the white skirt sweater, the blue sweater with the baby blue. It is just perfect for night out. This used the same sweater to have another outfit that was much more like street style, much more like laid back, and just to give you really two nice, very different type of outfits. And if you really want to see that kind of light color ish, the back here was really, wouldn't say detailed, but it was a really nice combination because the skirt was white, the boots were white, really nice piece again here, accessory that actually tied up the whole outfit altogether. And actually play with the same shade. You don't have to like mix match like the pastel colors if you're not used to do it. But it's not a nice way. And when it comes to like using the same shade of the color, I had another outfit, and this one was my dress from Zara. It has much more like princess type. It's not plain like the white skirt and the blue sweater. With it, what I chose to do is to nail around it really plain. So I had my mules, and then I had my dusty pink coat that you've seen a lot of times. So this time it was all about still playing with the same shade here, shade of like pink, the same shade but with prints. A way to actually go a little bit beyond like the way to just have the plain colors. So if you like much more like comfortable like with pastel colors, I think this one is really nice because you play with the prints but you're still staying in the same shade of color. Really cute, and it's a matter of playing with prints but without having to do too much to it because this is pastel. Pastel colors are just made to be able to not overdo it. It's another step ahead when it comes to like combining the plain colors or staying within the same shade. Now we can actually mix match but adding just a little bit of like interesting accessory. Again, my last outfit for me was just amazing just because this time you're combining the prints and the colors. And let me tell you that it was so fun for me to do. I did it. Pink one was my blue polka dot top, right? It was blue and it was a really nice yet simple print. When you see the yellow pants, it's a light yellow. How the polka dot, it's a super blue, but then you have a bit of the bright yellow, really plain brightly yellow. The combination was again really easy. And for the shoes, I added these ones. It's the best because it's pink, so it's not the same colors, so it's really a matter of taking risk here. But what I like about it is the buckle, the gold buckle, because it reminds you of the yellow of the pants. And because of that, it doesn't look awkward just because of that little connection here. Even with the really different color, you can actually tie them on just because of that. Added another bag, and I really chose to stay within the same color as my shoe. You can play with the shade here. You can have many shades of the same color, even if you have much more like color on your outfit. This one was, it wasn't complicated, but it was definitely something super super comfortable, like having to wear that kind of pastel colors because it was bright, it was colorful, but then again it's light. Okay, so I just hope you liked it. Most favorite outfit, just because itself, I'm not somebody that would be able to just match so many colors, so I was actually really surprised by myself doing that. That's it for me for today. I hope it helped you. I hope it gave you a lot of like options when it comes to it. I hope you're gonna like it. If you did, just let me know. I'm gonna be more than glad to do videos like that. And if you like that type of videos, definitely let me know. And I would be more than glad to do it again. If you really like this video, just check out my magazine because there's gonna be a lot more information there. It's gonna be much more like in depth, much more in details as how you can do it yourself. Of course, I'm gonna see you guys next week for my next video. So until then, have a beautiful weekend, have a great end of the week, and smile because it's free. Bye. J'espère que vous avez aimé la vidéo. Si vous avez des questions, n'hésitez vraiment pas. Je serai toujours disponible à répondre à tout, français, anglais, espagnol, japonais. Je serai disponible. If you have any question, don't forget to get back at me. English, French, Spanish, Japanese, I'll be more than glad to actually answer you. Merci les amis pour avoir regardé ma vidéo. Je vais vous voir la semaine prochaine. Et si vous aimez ce type de vidéo, n'hésitez surtout pas à me laisser savoir parce que je serais plus que ravie d'en faire d'autres comme ça parce que j'adore ça. Un, j'adore parler et deux, j'adore donner des espèces d'astuces et tout parce que je trouve que ça aide tout le monde. Pas juste moi, mais ça vous aide aussi. Et c'est pour ça que je fais ces vidéos-là de toute façon. Donc, d'ici là, je vous souhaite un super beau week-end. Je vous revois la semaine prochaine et je vous fais de gros bisous. Bye!